This is Will with TNW Digital Marketing. Thank you for clicking on this video for me. Really quick, I'm going to show you three easy tips on how to improve your website to start bringing you more customers today. The point of this video is really simple and straight to the point because a lot of business owners don't have the time to learn how to make the internet work for them and bring them more customers in today's world. So that's holding them back from hiring marketing agencies because they don't know who is an expert and who is not in today's world. So I found by making these attack plans and giving them out for free, some business owners will do it themselves and some call me back and ask for some help. So if you do want some help at the end of this, you can give me a call and we can chat more. If you want to do this yourself, please do so. I'm just trying to help out as many business owners as I can possible, like I mentioned previously. So first off, I'm going to talk to you about content, backlinks, and citation. And first, I want to talk to you about content. So right now, let's jump into your website. I like how you have your logo and everything right here set up on the front. You have the click to call, you have the insurance claims, and then you have all your services. I like how you have your pictures pop up. You're telling them about what's going on. It looks really nice. I like how you have some insurance claim pictures going on as well. But unfortunately, Google doesn't rank you based off of how your website looks. They rank you based off of how much right content you have. So if somebody types in roofing contractor Amarillo, Texas, Google's goal is to put them in front of the article that's going to answer all those questions, and which typically is the article that has the most words on it, right? So the average website on the front page of Google has 1,890 words on it. So you're going to want to set yourself right around 1,500, if not 2,000 words. And you guys, so I've already put you guys in your top competitor, which is Mayfield Roofing. I've put you two in a word counter already, and so you guys are currently sitting at 405 words, and your competitor is sitting at low 284, and they're at the number one spot. So if you go out and you go get that 1,500 and if not 2,000 word count on your front page, you're already going to be beating them in that number one factor when it comes to ranking for Google. So then what I wanted to talk about is with these pictures right here, you can also save them, because you can save these pictures as like Amarillo, Texas roofing. So you have roofers in Amarillo, Texas. Yes, exactly. So that's exactly how it's supposed to go. Let's see right here. We have roofers in Amarillo, Texas. So yes, that's exactly what I was gonna say. Those phrases and keywords, they help you rank as well in that in those factors. So that's tip number one. Tip number two is you want to make yourself more trustworthy. And what I mean by that is Google also judges you based off of how many other websites are linking to you. You don't want to just get any old websites linking back to you, because it's like a popularity contest. So it's just like how it was in high school. You get the most votes, you win, right? The most popular people are voting for you, you're going to win that. So you don't want to just go out and get any old links. You want to get the most relevant websites linking to you. You want to get a lot more, you'll get a lot more power from other roofing companies linking to you, other than like Pizza Hut linking to you, because Google knows you're not a pizza company. I use this tool myself. It's called Ahrefs, and it costs me about $1,000 a month. But it can give you some real valuable data that's going on the back end of the websites. So it's not 100% accurate, but it's pretty accurate. It's about the 95-98 percentile, to where I can still see what's going on through your website and what's helping you rank and all of those key factors. So right here you can see you have 231 backlinks with 48 referring domains and 31 organic traffic, and your competitor is actually sitting at, we're 59 backlinks, 11 referring domains with 275 organic traffic coming back to them. So as you can see, you have more backlinks and referring domains, but theirs might be more powerful. And so the way to do that, and the way to beat them in that, all you do is you'll just go in and click these right here, click these areas, and you can either create an account with these different companies or just click contact us and ask them for a link, because whichever websites are linking back to them, they can also link back to you as well. But just imagine if you're beating them with content, beating them with links, you're going to take over their organic rankings, which means you're going to take over the organic traffic as well. So imagine having that 275 new clients coming to your website each and every month for the whole month, building up new clientele. That's a ton more business, right? That's why it's so important to plant all these different factors into your website. So that's tip number two. And tip number three is the last thing that I wanted to go over, which is when someone goes into Google, and they type in Amarillo Roofing, Amarillo, Texas, like I have right here, and they're ready to buy. They call the first roofing company that seems the most trustworthy to them and the most powerful and most honest. And so you want to be that first roofing company because those are the easiest customers to close because they need your service right then and right away. So people typically skip these ads right here just because they either have an ad blocker or just from bad experience from previous experiences that they had. So what they do is they skip that and go right here into this this section right here, which is called the local map pack section. So getting here requires having more citations than your competitors. That's anywhere where your name, phone number, and addresses is listed in directories like Yelp, Yellow Book, WebAdvisor, AngieList, etc. Those are just the most common ones, but there's tons and tons and tons, a bunch more that you can get into. So the best strategy here is to figure out which directories the top three competitors are in and list yourself in those same directories, and then add a bunch more on top of that, like we were saying for with the backlinks. So if they're in right around 100 and 200 directories, put yourself in 250, if not 300, just so Google can show Google that you're on top of that competitor, and you're on top of that, and you can blow them out of the water. So, all right, that's all I have for you today. I hope you did find this informative and helpful. Here's just a quick recap of everything I was saying. You want to go out, get that 1,500, if not 2,000 word count to blow them out the water. Come and get these backlinks, copy them, and referring domains, and make sure you add yourself into them. And then come and get these directories, putting all your information to where you can get listed as being verified for Google as well. So if you do want to do all of this yourself, please do so. This is a free educational video just trying to help out, like I've mentioned previously. I just want to help out as many as I can possible. The only thing that I ask for you to give me is to give me some call me and to give me some feedback to let me know how this video was helpful and have valuable information on it. And if you want any help at the end of this, you can reach us at 682-202-4804. You can also email us back at tnw@seofortworth.org. Thank you. Have a great day.